Hello students, so today we will start a new chapter, that is chapter 7, control and coordination. Now in this control and coordination, if you just see that the one of the property of the living organism is that living organism, they show growth, okay, or first they show the movement. Now if the living organism show the movements, we see that the plants, we don't see the movements in the plants. Plants mein toh humein movements dikhti nahin, but the plants do move. How we saw a seed in the soil and after some time a seedling come out, then there is a growth, the leaves are formed, the stem keeps on increasing. Now such type of movements which we see in the plants, these are growth related movements. So the type of movements which we see in the plants, they are growth related movements. Now other type of movements which are seen in the living organism, these are visible movements, because in the plants these movements are not visible, but we can see that the movements do occur in the plants when the growth takes place. In other organism we say visible movements are there. What are visible movements? That means when we see the movements are there in response to the change in the environment. Suppose environment mein koi change hota hai, to us change ke against we show certain responses, and those responses which we show against the environment, they are in a form of movement. Let us take an example. Suppose there is a cat. When a cat sees a mouse, the cat run after the mouse. Why? Because initially the mouse is not there, but then the mouse came in the environment. That means there is a change in the environment. How? Because the mouse came in the environment and the cat starts running after the mouse. So this type of movement is the movements which occur because there is some change in the environment, and those that change in the environment shows, because of that the movement is seen. Still other organisms are there which take the advantage of the change in the environment, like the plants, they grow towards the light. Why? Because they want to take the light. Why do they want to take the light? Because they want to do the photosynthesis. Or a very simple example you can take, that there is a rain. So we can see that some change is there in the environment, ki barish aa rahi hai, and just to take the advantage of the shady place, we run from the rain towards a shade because we want to take the advantage of that shade, and that is how we see the movements. Jitni bhi tarah ki ye movements hai, chahe wo plants ke andar hain, chahe wo animals ke andar hain, chahe wo response to the environment hain, ya we want to take the advantage of the environment, all these movements, they are controlled, they are very carefully controlled by a system in our body, and that is known as a nervous system. So jitni bhi movements hain jo hamari body ke andar hoti hain, they are controlled movements. And what controls these movements? It is the nervous system which controls these movements. So careful control movements, they are connected to the events of the environment. What does it mean? Sometimes we show the movements because there is some change in the environment. Like if the teacher is not there, the students, they laugh, they sing, they fight. But the moment the teacher enters, that means there is a change in the environment, so they go to their places and sit, okay. So that means they are careful movements, because the students are very careful that when the teacher comes, they don't fight, okay. So careful control movements are also there. It occurs because there is some change in the environment. Wo kaun si change environment mein hoti hai? The teacher is there. Initially she or he is not there, but when the teacher enters, there is a change in the environment, so the student shows this movement. So jitni bhi movements hain, जितनी भी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म के अंदर मूवमेंट होती हैं, दीज आर कंट्रोल्ड मूवमेंट्स एंड दे आर कोऑर्डिनेटेड मूवमेंट्स. कोऑर्डिनेटेड का मतलब है लाइक देर इज़ अ सम कंट्रोलिंग सिस्टम एंड दैट कंट्रोलिंग सिस्टम मेक द अदर सिस्टम टू डू द कोऑर्डिनेशन विद इट. लाइक जैसे हमने कुछ सोचा या कुछ देखा तो हमें वहाँ से भागना है. सपोज हम जा रहे हैं तो हमने लॉयन देखा, उसके हिसाब से यू नो दिस देर इज़ अ चेंज इन द एनवायरमेंट एंड वी वॉन्ट टू रन. वेन वी वॉन्ट टू रन वी यूज़ आर मसल्स. सो आवर नर्वस सिस्टम जो है इट कंट्रोल्स एंड कोऑर्डिनेट्स विद द वेरियस टिश्यूज टू शो द मूवमेंट. ओके, दैट अकर इन द मल्टी सेलर ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो ऑल दिस इज जस्ट टू टेल यू दैट इन आर बॉडी वन सिस्टम इज देयर विच इज़ नोन एज अ नर्वस सिस्टम एंड दिस नर्वस सिस्टम कंट्रोल्स एंड कोऑर्डिनेट ऑल द मोमेंट्स विच अकर इन आर बॉडी. नाउ ये जो नर्वस सिस्टम है, इन दिस चैप्टर विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट टू सिस्टम्स. वन इज नर्वस सिस्टम, अदर इज एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम. नाउ फर्स्ट विल टॉक अबाउट द नर्वस सिस्टम. This nervous system and the muscular system means all the muscles are included in this muscular system, which is made up of muscular tissue also. Okay, now what is the function of this nervous system? Nervous system, when something, we feel the touch of something, how we feel that something is touching us, because we detect दैट टच. हमें वो टच का पता चलता है और उस टच के अगेंस्ट हम रिस्पॉन्स करते हैं. से फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द मोमेंट वी टच अ हॉट ऑब्जेक्ट, सो वी टच अ हॉट ऑब्जेक्ट, वी डिटेक्ट दैट दिस इज़ वेरी हॉट एंड देन वी शो द रिस्पॉन्स. सो द फंक्शन ऑफ द नर्वस सिस्टम इज दैट द डिटेक्शन ऑफ एनी स्टिमुलस इज देयर and we give the response to that stimulus. So that is a response to the environment. Now how we give the response to the environment, hum kaise response karte hain environment ko. The nervous system is made up of special type of cells. Ye jo hamara nervous system hai, like we talked about the excretory system, the structural and functional unit of excretory system is nephrons. Then we talked about the respiratory system. द लंग्स जो हैं, इनका स्ट्रक्चरल और फंक्शनल यूनिट कौन सा है लंग का? एल्वियोलाई. सिमिलरली नर्वस टिश्यू जो है, द नर्वस सिस्टम, द स्ट्रक्चरल एंड फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ द नर्वस सिस्टम, दीज आर द नर्व सेल्स और द न्यूरोन्स आर देयर. दैट न्यूरोन्स आर देयर. नाउ वी शो द रिस्पॉन्स टू द एनवायरमेंट. We show the response to the environment, any type of response to the environment, because there are special tips or special receptors are present. Special receptors are present at the tip of the nerve cells. ये जो nerve cells हैं, the nervous system is made up of nerve cells, और nerve cells की tip में जो उनकी tip है उसमें certain receptors are present. Okay, so these receptors, the function of these receptor is they can detect any response, they can detect any stimulus in the environment, and our body show the response to that environment or to that stimulus. So here we are concerned with the nerve cells, and the special tip of the nerve cells, they have certain receptors. Now to tell you more about the receptors, ये जो receptors हैं ये हमारे sensory organs में होते हैं. And you know there are 5 sensory organs: ear, nose, tongue, eyes and skin. These are 5 sense organs, and in these sense organs the neurons are there, and at the neurons means nerve cells, and at the tip of the nerve cells the receptors are there. Take for example, there are taste receptors. Now this taste receptors kahan pe present hai? They are present on the tongue. So on the tongue a certain type of neurons are there, or the nerve cells are there, and the receptors of those nerve cells are known as the taste receptors. Okay, because we feel whether the what is the taste of a particular thing. Okay, now these taste receptors which are present on the tongue, they are known as the gustatory receptors. So you have to remember, what are gustatory receptors? Gustatory receptors are the taste receptors which are present on the tongue. Similarly, जो nose है हमारा, उसमें भी receptors हैं, क्योंकि हमें smell पता चलती है. So nose के tip, nose पे the smell receptors are there, and these smell receptors which are present in the nose, they are known as the olfactory receptors. So remember, olfactory receptors are the receptors present in the nose through which we feel the smell. The third is hearing receptors. कि हम सुनते कैसे हैं, कहाँ से सुनते हैं, हम कानों से सुनते हैं. वी हेयर विद द हेल्प ऑफ द ईयर्स, एंड ईयर्स के अंदर सर्टन रिसेप्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट, द हेयरिंग रिसेप्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट, एंड दीज हेयरिंग रिसेप्टर्स आर नोन एज द ऑडिटरी रिसेप्टर्स. सो ऑडिटरी रिसेप्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द ईयर विच आर हेयरिंग रिसेप्टर्स. सिमिलरली आइज के अंदर रिसेप्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट, एंड with the help of those receptors we can see a particular object. So the receptors which are present in the eyes, they are known as the optic receptors. So optic receptors are present in the eyes. Similarly, how we can feel ki garmi hai ki thand hai ki hame kuch cheez pinch kar rahi hai, we feel that thing through the skin. So there in the skin certain receptors are present which are known as the feeling receptors, and these feeling receptors are known as the touch receptors. So five sense organs mein the gustatory receptors are there, olfactory receptors are there, auditory receptors are there, optic receptors are there, and the touch receptors are there. And all these receptors are present at the tip of the nerve cells, and these nerve cells are actually the structural and the functional unit of the nervous system. So that means hame nerve cells ke bare mein pura detail mein pata hona chahiye. Now let us talk about the neuron or the nerve cell. Let us talk about the structure of the neuron. Is slide mein main tumhe structure of the neuron bataungi, and next slide mein I'll show you the diagram. Now when we talk about a neuron, there is one structure, very small branched tree like structures are there, which are known as the dendrites. So dendrites in the neurons can be one dendrite or two dendrites or many dendrites. Okay, now the dendrites are small tree like structures. Now function of these dendrites, that is to receive the information. बाहर से इंफॉर्मेशन, बाहर से कोई भी जो स्टिमुलस आता है, बाहर से कोई भी स्टिमुलस आता है, तो दैट इज़ रिसीव्ड बाय द डेंड्राइट, डेंड्राइटिक टिप, द टिप ऑफ द डेंड्राइट, इट रिसीव द इंफॉर्मेशन. व्हेन इट रिसीव द इंफॉर्मेशन, सर्टन केमिकल रिएक्शन टेक्स प्लेस, सर्टन केमिकल रिएक्शन टेक्स प्लेस, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दोज केमिकल रिएक्शन दैट stimulus is converted into electric impulse. So certain chemical because of certain chemical reaction, the stimulus which is received by the dendritic tip, that is changed into the electric impulse. Now this electric impulse from the dendrites, it enter to the main body of the neuron, which is known as a cell body. So what is the cell body? Cell body is the main body of a neuron. मैं next slide में तुम्हें diagram दिखाऊंगी, it will become very clear to you. Okay, so what is a cell body? Cell body is the main body of a neuron in which the nucleus is present. So from the dendrite, the electric impulse enters into the cell body, that is the main body of a neuron. Then from the cell body, one nerve fiber arises, only one nerve fiber. Dendrites can be many, but this one nerve fiber which arises from the cell body, that is known as an axon. So what enters into the cell bodies? Dendrites enter into the cell body, because the dendrites, they take the nerve impulse or the electric impulse and bring that electric impulse to the main body of the neuron. From this main body of the neuron, this electric impulse enters into axon, and the axon is only one. Axon jo hai wo ek hi hai. It is a fiber. Even dendrites are fibers. Okay, but these are very short tree-like structures, where axon jo hai, it is long fiber and it is only one. Ek neuron mein ek hi axon hota hai. And the function of the axon is that the function of axon is to take the nerve impulse or the electric impulse from the cell body. Now, axon ke end mein, axon ke tip mein, the end of the axon, the nerve endings are there. Axon ke tip mein, axon is one, but it ends into many nerve endings. So what are nerve endings? Nerve endings are present at the end of the axon. Okay. Now, nerve endings mein, there is one chemical is released from those nerve endings. Jo nerve endings ye axon ke end mein present hoti hain, un nerve ending mein se ek chemical release hota hai, and the name of the chemical, mostly many chemicals are there, one is known as an acetylcholine. So acetylcholine is known as a neurotransmitter. Okay, why it is known as a neurotransmitter? Because through this acetylcholine, the impulse, the electric impulse jo hai, it changes into the chemical impulse. What is acetylcholine? It is a chemical. It is a chemical. So electric impulse from the dendrite enters into the cell body. From the cell body, it enters into the axon. From the axon, the electric impulse goes in the end of the axon. At the end of the axon, a chemical is released, which is known as an acetylcholine. And this acetylcholine is a chemical which is released in the synapse. Now, ab synapse kya hai? One neuron is connected to another neuron. Again, I'll show you the synapse in one of the slides. This synapse jo hai, it is a small gap. Synapse is a small gap which is present between the two neurons. Though, because this information from one neuron has to go to the next neuron. So two neurons are connected with each other through the synapse. Now, yahan pe functional connection hai, but physical connection nahi hai. That means the two axons are not physically connected, but functionally connected. Kaise functionally connected hai? Through the acetylcholine. So the electric impulse enter into the synapse and change into the chemical impulse. Now this chemical impulse again enter into the next neuron, and it again changes into the electric impulse. So we start from the electric impulse, it goes into the main body of the cell, then to the axon, then the end of the axon or the nerve endings, then this chemical is released. Through this chemical, the electric impulse changes into chemical impulse, and then through this synapse, the impulse again changes into the electric impulse, and again this electric impulse jo hai, it enters into the dendrite of the next neuron. So this is how the nerve impulse travels from one neuron to the another neuron. Okay, now ye to maine tumhe bata diya, but before that you must know what is the structure of a neuron. न्यूरॉन का स्ट्रक्चर पता होना चाहिए. नाउ दिस इज़ अ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द न्यूरॉन. मैंने तुम्हें पहले बताया कि न्यूरॉन कंसिस्ट ऑफ मैनी ट्री लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. ये देखिए, ये ट्री लाइक स्ट्रक्चर है, ब्रांच स्ट्रक्चर है. लाइक दिस इज अगेन ब्रांच स्ट्रक्चर, दिस इज अगेन ब्रांच स्ट्रक्चर, दिस इज अगेन अ ब्रांच स्ट्रक्चर, एंड दीज आर नोन एज द डेंड्राइट्स. दीज आर नोन एज द डेंड्राइट्स. द फंक्शन ऑफ द डेंड्राइट इज to bring the impulse towards the cyton. Cyton kya hai? This is the main body of a neuron. जहाँ पे न्यूक्लियस प्रेजेंट है, दिस इज़ अ न्यूक्लियस. न्यूक्लियस के बाहर जो है साइटोप्लाज्म है. सो जहाँ पे न्यूक्लियस और साइटोप्लाज्म प्रेजेंट है, दैट इज़ नोन एज अ सेल बॉडी, मेन बॉडी ऑफ अ न्यूरोन. इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज साइटोन. ओके, सो डेंड्राइट ब्रिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन और द इम्पल्स टू द साइटोन. वो इम्पल्स को यहाँ से साइटोन में लाते हैं. देन फ्रॉम द साइटोन ओनली वन लॉन्ग नर्व फाइबर अराइज. ये देखिए, एक लंबा सा नर्व फाइबर है. एक ही नर्व फाइबर है, काफ़ी लंबा है, एंड इट इज़ ओनली वन, इट इज़ नोन एज एन एक्सॉन. सो ये यहाँ से लेके पूरा ये एक्सॉन फुल नर्व फाइबर है, ऑल दिस नर्व फाइबर टिल हेयर इट इज़ वन एंड इट इज़ नोन एज एन एक्सॉन. नाउ इफ़ वी सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एन एक्सॉन, ये बीच के अंदर ये एक्सॉन कहाँ है, ये बीच में जो है दैट इज़ एन एक्सॉन. दिस एक्सॉन इज सराउंडेड बाय अ शीट, ये जो ब्लू कलर की शीट दिख रही है, दिस इज़ अ शीट, दैट मीन्स एक्सॉन सेंटर में है एंड इट इज़ सराउंडेड बाय अ शीट एंड दैट शीट इज़ नोन एज अ माइलिन शीट. सो व्हाट इज़ माइलिन शीट? माइलिन शीट और मेडुलरी शीट भी इसको कहते हैं और माइलिन शीट भी बोलते हैं. सो दिस मेडुलरी शीट और द माइलिन शीट इज़ द शीट विच सराउंड द एक्सॉन, और द एक्सॉन इज सराउंडेड बाय द मेडुलरी शीट. एंड ये जो मेडुलरी शीट के बाहर, ये कैन यू सी दिस स्मॉल, दीज आर न्यूक्लियस, दीज आर न्यूक्लियस. नाउ न्यूक्लियस आर प्रेजेंट इन द सेल, माइलिन शीट इज़ नॉट अ सेल. सो माइलिन शीट के बाहर वन टाइप ऑफ सेल्स आर देयर, वन टाइप ऑफ सेल्स आर देयर एंड दीज सेल्स, दिस इज़ वन सेल, दिस इज़ अनदर सेल, दिस इज़ अनदर सेल. सो दीज सेल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट आउटसाइड द माइलिन शीट दैट आर नोन एज द Schwann cells. So Schwann cells are the cells which are present outside the myelin sheet. सबसे अंदर एक्सॉन है, ये एक्सॉन है. एक्सॉन is surrounded by the medullary sheet. Medullary sheet on its outer side have certain cells and these cells are known as the Schwann cells. Now can you see, यहाँ पे जो है medullary sheet नहीं है, यहाँ पे medullary sheet नहीं है. सिमिलरली यहाँ पे medullary sheet नहीं है, सिमिलरली यहाँ पे मेडुलरी शीट नहीं है. सो देर आर सर्टन पॉइंट्स ऑन द एक्सॉन, एक्सॉन में बहुत से ऐसे पॉइंट्स हैं जिसमें मेडुलरी शीट इज एब्सेंट. दिस इज मेडुलरी शीट, तुम देखो ये यहाँ पे ख़त्म हो जाती है और यहाँ पे ये पॉइंट जो है यहाँ मेडुलरी शीट नहीं है, अगेन यहाँ पे मेडुलरी शीट है. सो दोज पॉइंट्स इन विच द मेडुलरी शीट is absent, they are known as the rod node of Ranvier. So what are node of Ranvier? Node of Ranvier are the places where the myelin sheet is absent, where the myelin sheet is absent. So and this is a total is the axon, this is a complete axon and the tip of the axon, yahan pe axon jo hai wo khatam hone wala hai, so it gives many axonal endings and these endings enter into button like structures which are known as the axon terminal buttons. So this is an axon. The function of the axon is it always take the information from the cytone. The dendrites bring the information towards the cytone and this information from the cytone is carried forward to the axon, and this information when enters into the terminal part of the axon, then this terminal part of the axon is connected with another axon, another nerve cell. This is one nerve cell, this nerve cell is connected with another nerve cell, then second nerve cell is also connected with third nerve cell. Okay, so how the connection is there? As I told you, one nerve neuron is connected with another neuron by a small gap is there and that gap is known as a synapse. Wo synapse mein a chemical is released that is known as an acetylcholine. Yahan se jo information aa rahi hai that is in a form of an electric impulse. So dendrites jo information la rahe hain, it is in a form of electric impulse. That from the dendrite the impulse come to the cytone, from the cytone, cytone means cell body, from the cell body the information goes to the axon, that is in the form of an electric impulse. But at the end of the axon where these buttons are present, through this, in this button the chemical is released which is known as an acetylcholine. So this electric impulse changes into chemical impulse at the synapse, synapse means gap. And then again when the nerve impulse passes through the gap, again it is converted into electric impulse, and that electric impulse that enter into the next neuron. Just to tell you, this is a neuron, दिस इज़ अ न्यूरोन. नाउ दीज आर ऑल डेंड्राइट्स. ये जो हैं ये सारे डेंड्राइट्स हैं. सो डेंड्राइट्स जो हैं वो इंफॉर्मेशन ला रहे हैं टू द मेन बॉडी ऑफ द न्यूरोन, दैट इज़ अ सेल बॉडी. ये न्यूक्लियस है. तो यहाँ से जो इम्पल्स है दैट गोज़ इन टू द एक्सोन. ये एक्सोन है, एक एक्सोन है. दिस इज़ एक्सोन एंड दिस इज़ एंड ऑफ द एक्सोन. ये एंड ऑफ द एक्सोन जो है इट हैज़ अ नोब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर एंड दिस नोब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर और द एंड ऑफ द एक्सोन दे आर कनेक्टेड विद द डेंड्राइट्स. ये फिर डेंड्राइट्स हैं, बट दीज डेंड्राइट्स आर ऑफ सेकेंड न्यूरोन. दिस इज अ सेकेंड न्यूरोन, दिस इज अ फर्स्ट न्यूरोन, दिस इज अ सेकेंड न्यूरोन. ओके, सो दिस टू न्यूरोन्स आर कनेक्टेड विद ईच अदर थ्रू द सैनैप्स. सो यहाँ पे एक स्मॉल स्पेस है विच इज़ नोन एज ए सैनैप्स. सैनैप्स इज अ पॉइंट विच कनेक्ट्स द टू न्यूरोन्स और द टू नर्व सेल्स, दैट इज नोन एज ए सैनैप्स. और इस सैनैप्स में द वन न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर विच इज़ नोन एज एन एसिटाइल कोलिन दैट इज सिक्रीटेड. उसका फंक्शन क्या है? टू कन्वर्ट द इलेक्ट्रिक इम्पल्स. यहाँ से जो इम्पल्स आ रहा है इट इज़ इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक इम्पल्स. टू कन्वर्ट द इलेक्ट्रिक इम्पल्स इन टू केमिकल इम्पल्स. अगेन दैट केमिकल इम्पल्स इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू इलेक्ट्रिक इम्पल्स एंड गोज इन टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूरोन. ओके, नाउ दिस इज अगेन एन एक्सोन. नाउ दिस इज अनदर थिंग दैट हाउ वी शो द मसल कंट्रैक्शन. Now this is a muscle, this is a muscle. Now how, when and how this muscle shows the contraction. ये contract कब करती है और relax कब करती है. Now this is again an axon which is bringing the impulse. कहाँ से ला रहा है? वो cell body से. वो impulse ला रहा है through the axon. ये axon का terminal portion आ गया और terminal portion में these are the nerves और द नर्व एंडिंग्स. यहाँ पे एसिटाइल कोलिन रिलीज हो जाता है एंड दैट एसिटाइल कोलिन जो है थ्रू दिस एसिटाइल कोलिन और थ्रू दिस केमिकल दिस नर्व इम्पल्स एंटर इनटू द मसल. दिस नर्व इम्पल्स एंटर इनटू द मसल. ओके, एंड दैट इज़ हाउ द मसल गेट कंट्रैक्टेड. नाउ द जंक्शन इन विच द दिस एंड ऑफ द एक्सोन दे आर कनेक्टेड functionally with the muscle, that is known as a neuromuscular junction. Neurons means nerve ka, muscles ka junction hai. Aur ye neuromuscular junction mein kya present hai? Neurotransmitter is present. Kaun sa neurotransmitter? Acetylcholine is present. So, acetylcholine ka kya function hai? To change the electric impulse into chemical impulse and again this chemical impulse that is changed into electric impulse. Clear? So again this diagram also shows this is an axon. This is a knob like structure, that is the end of the axon. ये जो हैं ये mitochondria हैं and this is another axon. यहाँ बीच में ये जो space है यहाँ पे acetylcholine और the neurotransmitter जो है that is released. So this is a synapse and the function of the synapse is to connect the two neurons. I think we'll finish it up here only. Next time we'll be talking about further. Thank you, students.